Hello friends, hope you're doing well. Welcome back to our channel, and today we'll get started with SpaceX carrying out the final stage of Booster 7 testing before hopping into orbital test flight. While Artemis 1 is doing well in its mission, SpaceX, on the other hand, is preparing itself to carry out orbital flight test within this year. Though the whole of the Starship program is quite interesting, but still, the Super Heavy booster part of the Starship vehicle has caught the attention of most of the Starship fans for quite a long time. Armed with 33 super powerful Raptor engines, the rocket is aiming to become the most powerful booster the world has ever seen. Though SpaceX has yet to achieve the record of 33 engine ignition, but they're still gearing towards that goal. More than a fortnight ago, SpaceX had completed static fire of 14 Raptor V2 engines, and recently they've done another static fire test of Booster 7. As per reports, on November 29th, Tuesday, at 2:42 p.m. Eastern Time, SpaceX carried out the static fire test of Booster 7. Reports say that the test had lasted for 13 seconds. Visibly, the test was a powerful one, and it was expected that a good number of V2 Raptor engines may have been involved in the test. Later, SpaceX confirmed that the test was carried out on 11 of the Raptor engines. SpaceX tweeted that Booster 7 completed a long-duration static fire test of 11 Raptor 2 engines on the orbital launch pad at Starbase. The previous static fire test, held in early November, had fired 14 engines, so the recent test didn't make any new record on the number of engines fired. But as per some sources, this test has made some other achievement. The long-duration static fire test of 11 Raptors is really the longest period of time that so many Raptor engines have been fired at once. Earlier, Musk wrote, over on Twitter, that next test is about 20-second firing with max oxygen fill to test autogenous pressurization, possibly one more static fire, then orbital launch attempt. According to some sources, Tuesday's test may have been a slightly shorter version of this autogenous pressurization test, going for 12 seconds instead of 20. If that's the case, then Booster 7 is just a few steps away before participating in the orbital flight test. It's anticipated that SpaceX will conduct at least a short-duration test firing of all 33 Raptor engines simultaneously to gain confidence in the totality of the complex plumbing to fuel and pressurize the rocket's propulsion system. Then the Starship upper stage will be stacked on top of Super Heavy, and the combined vehicles must complete a wet dress rehearsal. While testing has been going on in B7, SpaceX is also working on Ship 24, too. As per sources, presently, Ship 24 is stationed on suborbital Pad B. SpaceX engineers are now repairing and modifying Ship 24 for the upcoming orbital flight. A good deal of scaffolding is seen around Ship 24, and SpaceX workers are seen working in Ship 24. As for now, the title of World's Powerful Rocket is held by NASA's Space Launch System Mega Rocket, which debuted on the 16th of November while carrying out agency's Artemis 1 mission. Once Starship successfully carries out the orbital flight, that title will be taken by Starship. As per the present pace of progression, it seems that SpaceX possibly can carry out the test within this year. As we come to a close for the day, let's take a look at an update regarding Starlink prices in Ukraine nearly doubling as mobile networks falter. Due to the increased demand for the SpaceX-produced satellite communication device and the failure of mobile networks as a result of Russia's attack on the nation's electrical grid, the list prices of Starlink communication devices have nearly doubled in Ukraine. According to the company website, the cost of Starlink terminals, which are manufactured by Elon Musk's SpaceX, will rise to $700 for new Ukrainian customers. Screenshots of previous pricing information shared by users inside the nation show that this is an increase from about $385 earlier this year. In order to avoid problems with domestic mail delivery, many Ukrainians purchase Starlink from the neighboring country of Poland. Prices there have increased, but those in Slovakia and the majority of other European nations have remained flat. The tiny portable gadgets, which link to satellites via a book-sized antenna, have given the Ukrainian military and civilians vital internet connectivity in regions with scant to no mobile phone networks or broadband service. It's unknown if pricing have changed for the Ukrainian government, which employs a variety of Starlink from different sponsors, including Musk's SpaceX, the Polish government, and NATO allies, as well as from crowdsourced supporters. According to a person familiar with the situation, SpaceX had just recently requested $4,500 per month from Washington in separate ongoing negotiations with the U.S. Department of Defense for each terminal destined for Ukraine. In relation to Starlink, the Pentagon has spoken with SpaceX, according to a Pentagon spokesman, who declined to go into further detail. According to him, satellite communications have been recognized by the U.S., and Ukraine is a vital tool for the military. Days after Russia began its full-fledged invasion of Ukraine, on February 24th, Musk activated connectivity for the satellite-based service there in response to a minister's request on Twitter. Since then, the Ukrainian military has made extensive use of Starlink along the front line, where months of fighting have rendered mobile networks unreliable, using enormous amounts of high-speed data to communicate with one another, with their bases, and to transmit high-resolution drone images. According to Prime Minister Denis Shmyhal, the Ukrainian government will import thousands of new Starlinks, duty and tax-free. Local retailers reported that there has been an increase in demand for Starlink recently due to the emergence of a small gray market where customers can pay up to $1,125 for the devices to be delivered right away rather than having to wait for SpaceX to deliver them from Poland or source them locally. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.